This conference will now be recorded.
So go to open. And in the training. Okay. Here. So I'm going to open our file. So here we chosen one line command. By the help of line, we are doing the practice how to draw the line, how to draw the rectangle, how to draw the circles, okay, and how to trim and extends and how to split the object. So far we discuss about these things. Today let us discuss about the modify commands. So these are the repetitive commands. Just I will touch and we will go into the project. See, now this is my rectangle, which is almost 13 meters. I want to move this line another 1000 mm. So whichever I want to move, select that object. When we select the object, so our modify commands will be contextual. See, in this modify commands, you can see first most command is the move. What is my task? I want to move this line to the 1000 mm. Select the move command. So first point and choose how much you want. Here you can enter the 1000. So what will happen? 13 meters become the 14 meters, means it's moved into the 1000 mm. So but what is happening along this line, this connected lines also getting moved. It's a stretching, but I don't want to stretch these objects. I want to move only particular object. To move the particular object, select, go to the move. Here you can see the two options. One is the constraint and the disjoint. So now I want to disconnect this relationship between these two lines, vertical line, horizontal line. So what I do, I will choose the option called disjoint. Remember, disjoint. Okay, so first point, second point, let's say. See, now subject is moved, it's not connected anymore. Let's say I want to move left side object. Select the object, go to the move, first point and second point. When I use this option disjoint, I'm able to disconnect between the objects. Let's say I'm going to draw one more rectangle. Go to the architecture line. Okay, let's say within this small rectangle. Now I want to move this line. Select the line, go to move. I want to remove the disjoint. What is happening? We are getting the stretch. In Revit, there is no specific stretch command. We need to use only this disjoint option. If we remove the disjoint, it get connected. If you switch on the disjoint, it will get disconnected. Let's say I want to move this object to somewhere else. Select the object, go to move, choose the base point, first point, wherever you want, you can move. Let's say I want to move this object end of this line. See, when I reach the end of this object, automatically I'm getting the O snaps. What are the O snaps? Yesterday we discussed, if you remember the things. In the manage snaps and O snaps is there. Here we have the endpoint, midpoint, nearest, like this. These commands automatically get enabled. Now, hello, I want to move this line to the middle of this line. Okay, select the line, go to move, choose the endpoint and reach the midpoint. When I am reaching into the middle of the object, I am getting the triangle symbol. See, this is the midpoint. Okay. And here, select the object. I am going to move once again. Move. Endpoint. See, I can move wherever I want. Okay. Let's say now I am going to draw one circle for our better understanding. Okay. Circle. So I want to fix the radius with the 1000. I'm going to click the radius option 1000. If I want to make it change, I can change it. Let's say I'm going to draw the circle here. Okay. I want to move this circle. Select the circle. Go to choose the move command. I'm repeating again and again because these are the very important things. Move. See, now I'm taking the center of the circle. Can you see? When I move my mouse, I'm getting the center. When I move, it's the one edge of the circle, I'm getting a quadrant. So I mean, O snaps will get activated automatically. If you switch off this O snaps, go to the manage, O snaps, switch off, go to the move command, will not get O snaps. So better always keep switch on. Select the circle, go to move, choose the center of the circle. Now I can able to place wherever I want, correct? Move, center of the object. I want to place end of this line. Clear? Wherever I want to, I can move the object by move command. Okay. See, next modify command is copy. So move, it will replace the position of the object. Copy, it will create the duplicate of the object. Let's say now I want to copy this circle into end of this line. Select the circle, go to the copy. I'm choosing center of the object. Here I want to move into the end of the line. See, another object has created. For example, this radius is 1000. I want to make this radius into 2000. Select it and change the dimension to the 2000. We can change it. And one more thing. Select the circle, go to the copy, choose. I can paste wherever I want. Okay. For example, I want to make it multiple times. Select the circle, go to the copy and use a multiple option. Can you remember multiple option? Okay. First point, like this, wherever you want, you can copy multiple times. Okay. Here. Now I'm going to copy circle. Here I can see the one more option called constraint. If you use the command move also, we are getting the constraint. And if you use the command copy also, we are getting the constraint. Okay. We have the constraint option for the move and copy. So this means is, see how it will work. When I click on the constraint, I can copy only in the right direction. I mean 0 degrees, 90 degree, 120 degree, 180 degree, 270 degrees. Okay, see, copy. I can go with the 0 degrees only. Ortho on, ortho off in the AutoCAD. Constraint means. Okay, if I switch off the constraint, I can copy wherever I want. Understood what is the constraint and what is the design? These are the most important things. You should note down this. Design and constraints. Disjoint means it will disconnect the relationship between the geometry. Constraint, it will behave to place in ortho on, ortho off.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, sir, in the first modify command, you have splitted the geometry. I mean, you have disjoined the elements, right?
Correct.
I did not get that processor. Is there any option called disjoining elements, or where did you click? I mean, how did you get that?
See, now I'm going to move this line. Okay, it's connected this
okay.
to this rectangle.
Okay,
so let the object go to the move. Okay,
yes.
So when I choose this disjoin option, it will disconnect relation between this horizontal line to vertical line.
Okay.
I will explain and go to the one more rectangle. Let's say, for example, now I want to move this object. Okay. I am removing this disjoin. That's the first point and second point. It's get connected. Can you see the difference? It is a stretching the object. When we use this disjoin, it's a disconnecting the property. It's not disconnecting.
Okay.
Again, if you select and copy the object, so disjoin, it get disabled because disjoin is not required for the copy. Copy means we duplicate the object. Okay. So in this copy, we have the option called constraint. Constraint means nothing but ortho on ortho. We can copy in the straight direction. I mean 0, 90, 180, 270 degrees only.
Okay.
If I remove the constraint, I can copy wherever I want.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay. See, now I want to delete this. So I have only one option, right? So next option is, when we go to the modify commands, command is the rotate. Okay. So in the rotate, let's say, for example, I want to rotate this line. Select the line, go to rotate. You should understand the concept. It's a Revit is very easy thing. Okay. When I select the line, I'm getting the modify commands. I'm going to use a rotate command. Whatever command I want to choose, I'm choosing from this menu only. Okay. By looking this icons only, we can identify which command is useful for which task. Let's say now I am going to rotate it. See, select the object, go to the rotate command. And here I would like to focus one thing is, whatever I want to modify, first I'm selecting the object. Okay, remember this is very important. I want to do some task, so I need to select the object first, then choose a command. Let's say in AutoCAD, what we do, first we enter the command, then we select the object and we do whatever we want. But here little bit difference. We need to select the object first, then choose the command. Say now I want to rotate this line. Select the line, go to rotate. When I use this rotate command, so base point, I mean supporting point, automatically will go into the center of the object. Can you see? Let's say I want to rotate it, choose another end and rotate in simple way. How much you want? Let's say select the object, go to rotate. Let's say I want to use angle basis. Let's say I want to rotate into the 45 degrees. Just 45, enter. It will rotate it 45 degrees. Then what is the base point? Center of the object. Okay. To understand clearly, I rotate this rectangle. Okay. Select the rectangle. Go to the rotate command. Let's say base point where I'm getting. Center of the object. Now if I give the angle to the 45 degrees, the 45 degrees automatically it will get rotated. For example, now I want to rotate this rectangle as base point is end of this corner. Okay, select the object, go to the rotate command, and here center of the rotation, place wherever we want, we need to place. See, I want to choose end of this object. When I move near to the object, I am getting the end O snaps. Okay, first point. I am holding the second edge, second point. How much I want to rotate, I can give the number. Let's say I want to give the 25 degrees. Enter. Understood? So everybody should practice this rotate. It's a little bit tricky. Just go to the rotate. Okay. Place after rotate, center of the rotation, place. Let's say I want to take this edge as a base point now. And I want to hold this line. See. Got it? So now I want to explain a little bit better way. Okay. I want to draw one triangle. To draw the triangle, I'm using the polygon. So how many sides I need to place it? Three sides. See. Let's say this is my triangle. I want to rotate with the help of this base point. Select that triangle, go to rotate, take the place, place it. I want to rotate based on this middle point of this line to this end of this line. Understood? Select the object, rotate, place. Okay, place the base point wherever you want. Choose the second option, rotate it. Right? So in the modify, okay. So at the moment, move, copy, rotate, trim or extend to the corner, trim or extend to single element, multiple elements, and delete. Okay, this delete, and we use the split command. So now these commands are enough to start our project. Other things we will discuss while doing in the practice. Okay, so here one thing is pin, unpin. I want to explain here. Pin means, for example, I don't want to disturb this line, I want to freeze this line, just go to unpin it. Means we cannot move this object. Okay, see, when you pin it, if you want to unpin, we need to select this object. But I am unable to select this object because here when you come into the bottom of this, okay, bottom of the here, if you see these symbols, okay, here also we can find the one pin symbol. It's blocked. You have to unblock. When you unblock, you can select the line, or else no. So for example, you want to move or do something on this one, you have to unpin it. Go to the modify and unpin. Now only you can move or you can rotate, you can do anything. Okay, see, for example, I don't want to disturb this triangle. Select the triangle and go to the move. Okay, if I want to try to move it, okay, cannot move pinned elements, means it's a fixed location. We are fixing the location of the object by pin. Okay, understood what is the importance of the pin? If you don't want to disturb some location of the object, just pin it. Clear? So now more or less we know how to draw the commands by using the lines and how to modify by modify. This is
seven explain split command.
Sorry,
split command.
I did not get you.
Split.
Flip.
Split. Split.
Split command.
Yes, sir.
So split command is Let's say, for example, I have one rectangle, okay? I have one line like this. Here, I want to remove this line. I want to trim it.
Okay.
So in AutoCAD, if you know AutoCAD, you can understand very easily. We can use the trim command and double enter. If you click here, it will get disappear, right? But in, we don't have this option. So we need to break it, split nothing but break. Go to the modify and use the split. Okay. Wherever you want to break it, click it. Okay. Then go to the trim or extend. See, perpendicular.
Okay.
Target and source. Which side you want to remove, you have to choose the opposite side. For example, okay. I want to remove this object. Okay. Select the target and source.
Okay. Thank you.
This to divide the objects, like how many times you can divide. So part number one, part okay. number two, part number three, part number like this. Right?
Okay.
So these are the very basic thing to work on the Revit. So far we are not really enter into the project. Okay. How Revit really helpful. Now, what we are going to do is here. Let's say, if our industry, what is our industry? AEC, correct? In the AEC means architecture, engineering, and construction. Okay. In AEC, we have the different disciplines. Number one discipline is architecture. Number two is the structure. Number three is the MEP. In MEP, we have the mechanical. Okay. Electrical and plumbing. Here we will get the fire fighting. See, if you want to construct one building, we need to create the structure model, we need to create the architecture model, we need to create the mechanical. Means here we are getting the HVAC. Everybody aware about it, I hope. And electrical, plumbing, firefighting. This thing we can see physically in the constructing the object. Okay. See, for example, now we are going to visit one site. Okay. Let's say what we can see in physically, we can see the structure part, we can see architecture part, we can see. If you go to the air conditioning system ducts and those things, we can see electrical lighting, conduits and cable trays, we can see, and plumbing feature, we can see, firefighting, we can see. Whatever we are going to construct on the site, we are constructing the Revit. Okay. Now what I do, first I will take the structure part. Generally, if you take the structure, what are the basic elements we can see in the structure? One is footing, second one is basic elements, columns, beams. Okay, right, physically we can see the footing, columns and beams. So now what we do, we start with the structure project by placing the columns, beams and footing. To start the structure project in Revit, we need to choose the proper template first. Whichever discipline you are going to work, we should choose a proper template. Without template, we cannot work in the Revit. We should remember this point again and again. I'm repeating. Without templates, we cannot start anything in the Revit. We should have the proper template. So now I'm going to start the structure. Right? When I go to the Revit, I'm closing this file. Okay. Go to new. We know already how to start the project. Okay. How to create the project. These things we discussed, how to start the project now. Again, I'm going to repeat. Now I'm going to the new. Which discipline I want to start now? It's a structure. Okay. I will go to the browse to choose my template. And by choosing the template, I need to focus on the units. In which units I am going to work, whether metric or imperial. Okay. Now I'm going to use the metric, means MM. Here we have the different templates, default, electrical, mechanical, structure, analysis default, something. So now what I do here, I will choose the structure analysis. Okay, nothing but structure template. What is the file format for the template? It's a .rte. Right? You should remember this file formats. Structure analysis. I'm selecting, go to the open. Now, open. Okay, so now after opening this, go to the file, save as project, say wherever I want to create it. Let's say here I want to go to training. Okay, here I want to create the project. Let's say I'm going to give the name as a STR. -1. This is my project name. Okay. So always going to save as. Here we need to focus on the backups to avoid the unnecessary space. But we should have the 2 to 3 backups for the safe side. And okay. And save. Right. Here. If you see my interface. Here we have the architecture, structure, and the systems. These are nothing but MEP, system nothing but MEP, structure, and architecture. If you see left side, I have the project browser. It's a complete project organization will happen in this project browser. It's nothing but Explorer. For example, I want to create one drawing in so and so folder. What I do, I will create the different folders. I will place my drawings in that particular folder. So in this Revit, whatever you want to perform your task, it will save in this organization only, project browser. And right side, we have the project properties. If you select any object, you can see the characteristics of that object. Again, I'm repeating, these four symbols are directions of my project. Okay. North direction, east direction, south, and west. These symbols represent elevation drawing of the project, which is available in the elevations. Elevation, building elevation, east elevation, north elevation, south, and west elevation. Then, so I save as my project as a structure, STR-1. Now, my first most task in the Revit to create the project is to create the levels. Can you see? Create the levels. Levels means floors. This means, let's say, for example, I have the 5-story building. First, I need to define the floor heights. I need to define that. How many floors I want to construct. Okay. Whether it is any discipline, take it architecture, take it structure, take it MEP. First to most task in the Revit to create the levels. Okay. So for example, I'm standing in front of one building. Somebody asked me how many floors are there. I can count, I can tell this is this many floors of the building. It's a 10 story building, 15 story building like this. How can I look it when I stand outside of the building only? I can check it. Correct. If I go inside of the floor, I cannot justify and I cannot give this answer to them. How many floors of this building? So here also, we need to go outside of the building, means we should enter into the elevation drawing in the Revit. Let's say if you go to this Revit here, I will go to the any one of the elevation. Let's say now I am going to into the south elevation of the building. Just go there and you can use the open or you can double click. When you go into the south elevation, here you can see the two levels, level one, level two. This is, let's say, elevation of this level is zero and elevation of this level is 3000. Okay, this indicates height of this floors. Now I want to create the different levels. To create the different levels, here I can see the datum, datum level. Okay, see, now I'm in the south elevation drawing. When you go to the south elevation drawing, I can see the level one and level two. Okay, I want to create the five story building, so I need to draw three more levels. So I will go to the datum, choose the level command. When I click on the levels in the draw commands, I can see line in the modify all modify commands. Okay, so why I focused on the draw commands, modify commands, now you can understand whatever you want to do with the help of these commands only. Okay, just I want to draw one line. I'm going there, first point, second point. See, now I got the level three. When I draw the level three in the project browser also, I'm getting the level three. Can you see here? See, level three, it's added. Okay. Now I want to add one more level. Level four, again it's added. I want to add one more level. Level five, okay, so add. Now see, level one, level two, level three, level four. So I'm unable to understand what is this level. I want to name it. Let's say ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor, roof, like this. Okay, just I want to select this level. When you select the level, I'm getting the properties of the level. Here, if you read carefully, elevation, okay, scope box, name. Okay, I want to change the name. To select the object, go to the property, change the name, name like ground floor. Okay, when I change the name, it will ask confirm level name, right? Would you like to rename corresponding view? If I click yes, this name will be changed in the project browser also. Can you see the ground floor? Now select the one more level. I'm going to change the name as first floor. Yes, it changed to the first floor. Okay, select one more. Second floor. Okay, see, now third floor. Let's say this is my room. So all names are changed here. Okay, roof, ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor, right? So I want same names to the left side of this level. Is select the level, click on the square box, select, click, select, click, select. Both side you can see the elevation. For example, you want to remove this, select and check the box. Select and check the box. Understood? Now, I changed the names of the each lever, but I want to change the elevation of the levels also. Okay? See, now this is a zero level. I am keeping as it is. Now I want to change the first floor into the 4 meters. Generally, fluoride will be the 3 meters. I can keep 3 meter as well. Now I am going to the change second level. Select the level. So how much? 3 plus 3, 6. Okay. Now, how much? 9 meters. I'm going to add 3 meters. Again, 9 plus 3. 12 meters. Okay. So now I want to check the dimensions. Let's say I will go to the annotate. I use the align dimensions. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to place outside of this. Can you see the dimensions? Okay, we will repeat once again. Okay. I want to place the dimensions. Okay, go to the annotate. Select the align dimension. Most of the times I'm going to use align only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now I define my the levels of the building. Okay. Now I'm going to save the project. And my next task in the process is to create the grids. Grids nothing but the reference lines to place the columns and foundations or anything. These are the reference. To draw the grids, I need to enter into the any one of the floor plan. Okay, so let's say now I want to go into the ground floor. I will go to the structural plans. I will go to the ground floor. Double click. I will enter into the ground floor plan. In ground floor drawing. Here I will draw my grids. Okay. See, I will go to the structure. Here I can see the datum grid. If you observe here, level is a disabled. Levels we can create only in the elevation parts. Remember carefully. Levels we can create only in these drawings, elevation drawings. Okay, so levels we can create only in this area only. Whether it is east, north, south, west, if you want to create the levels, you should go any one of the elevation. If you want to draw the grids, you can go to the any one of the floor plans. So now I can able to draw the grids. Select the grid. Again, I'm getting the draw commands, modify commands. Okay. I'm choosing the line. Let's say first point, second point. Okay. Again, grid. First point, second. See, numbers automatically it get increased. Third grade. Fourth grade. Fifth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I want to draw the horizontal grids. First point, second point. Okay. So I am getting the 6. But generally, we have the numbers for the vertical grids and the alphabets from the horizontal grids. Let's say I want to rename it. Select the grid. Go to the property. For anything, we need to go. Property here, name is there. I am going to change into the grid number A. Okay, so go to the grid, first point, second point, first point, second point, A, B, C, right? First point, second point. So automatically, we will get the incremental values. Now, just I draw the lines without any dimensions, any measurements. Now I want to make it according to the dimension. What I do, just I will go to the annotate. So place dimensions, I am going always to the annotation, right? Go to the align 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Place last point wherever we want. Okay, again vertical 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. So 5 meters, 5 meters, 4 meters. Okay, here you can see the 8 meters, 7 meters, 8 meters, 7 meters. Okay, 7 meter means 7000 mm. Here I want to make all grids equal. Okay, whatever I place at the dimension, select the dimension, and here you can see the EQ symbol. You should click on there. When you click it, it will get the equal dimension. But here we are getting the only EQ symbol. We don't know what is the value of that number. So to know this number, select the dimension, again go to the property. Here you can see the equality display. Go there and make the value. So now you can see the 4750, all 4750. But I want this between these two grids is let's say 4500, 4 meters, let's say 5 meters. Select any one of the grid. Remember carefully, this is select any one of the grid, so our dimension will get highlighted. Okay, which is highlighted in blue color, click on the dimension, make it 5000. Everything will get 5000. Now here I want to make it to the 7000. Select the dimension, click on the EQ. Okay, select the dimension, go to the property, here make it the value. Now select, can you see value? Now you can see the 7500 all equal. I want to make it to the 7000. Select any one of the grid. See, are you able to observe? One is we are getting in the black color, one is in the blue color. Which is highlighted in the blue color, select that one, change the dimension, 7 meters. Yes, somebody may get the doubt. So whatever I am doing, everything is in mm. Okay, to type this mm, I want to type 7000, but I don't have that much of patience. I want to convert into this dimension into the meters. Okay, so command is units. If you go to the manage, here you can see the project units. Can you see project units? If you click here, you will get the units. Here I will go to the length and I will change into the meters. Okay, here I can change into the precision value, just 1 decimal or 2 decimal. I'm going to use the 2 decimal. Automatically it will convert into the meters. Okay, but I want to work into the mm only. So I can use a shortcut. When I place a mouse, I can see the in bracket shortcut un, right? And if you type un also directly, you will get it. No enter. Go to the units, change into the millimeters. I don't want the precision for the millimeter. I will make it the 0 decimal. Now I can go into the grid. Okay, I'm going to save my project. This is a grid. Okay, for example, now I have the all equal dimension, but I don't want to equal dimensions. I want to first column to column distance in the different dimensions. So I will select the dimension, I will make it unequal. Click on this. Click unblock. Now, for example, first one is 7000, second one is 7500. I will make it 7500. Okay, see, it moved this side to the 6500. Again, I will select one more line. I will make into the 7000. Okay, again, this is 7500. We need to remove the constraint, equal constraint. Here I am keeping the equal constraint as it is. So can you see no block in the EQ symbol? Here you can see the, when you select the dimension, you can see the block in EQ. Okay. Now it's clear. So now I want to place my columns here. Okay, I'm in the ground floor. I want to place a columns. Okay, now I am going with the RCC columns. Okay, just to go to the structure. Here you can see the column. Just choose the column. When you click on the column, here I can see the type of the columns in the property. Okay, this is, I am going to use a concrete rectangular column, which is size is 600 by 750 mm, for example, first time. Okay, I want to place this column, the intersection of these two lines. Okay, when I move near to the grids, two grids are getting highlighted. I will place here in the ground. Okay, see, now I can see the column with the only black and white. If I want to see in detail view, I will go to the find and make it shaded. Okay, I can see the gray color now. Now just I'm going to place one more column. Go to the structure, column. Okay, choose the size of the column. Let's say this time I want to go to the 450 by 600. I'm coming to the intersection of the grids. I am placing here. Okay, see, for example, I placed this column. I want to check the dimension of these columns. Here you can see the 450 by 600. It's a name of the column only, but we don't know actual dimensions. If I want to check the dimension, again, go to the annotate dimension 1, 2, 3, 450 and 4. Okay, now I am going to place one more column, structure column. This time I'm going to use a 3300 by 450 column. See. Right? But unfortunately, my column size is, let's say, 600 by 1200. Okay. A column size is 600 by 1200. When I see in the property, I not found 600 by 1200 column. Now I want to create the new column size according to my project. So select any one of the column. Remember the steps carefully. Select any one of the column. Go to the edit type. Okay, so here already we have one size 600 by 750 and duplicate it 600 by 1200 mm. Just remember this is a name only. Okay, okay, and here width and height is there 600 by 1200 mm. Okay, it will change into the 600 by 1200 mm. Go to the annotate, select the align dimension 600 by 1200. Can you see 600 by 1200? Let's say for example I want to change this column 600 by 1200. Select it. Already we created one. This is a creation, is a one-time process. If you create one time, it's enough. It will store in the project. See, now you can change. Okay, select it. Now you can change it. I placed the three columns. In the three columns, third column is I want to place in the horizontal. It is vertically. Okay. To place is what I need to do. I need to go rotate. Select the rotate base point intersection of this column, first point and second. I rotated this column. Okay. So instead of doing this thing, just I will use the space bar. If you click the space bar, automatically it will get rotate. No need to use the rotate command also. Okay, select it, hit the space. It will get rotated. Right? Let's say, for example, you want the same size of the column. Select the column, go to copy. Okay, first point and parallel to the second. And copy wherever you want. Okay, so I want to rotate this now. Select it and space bar. Okay. You want to copy, select, copy, first point to the third. Fine, we are placing the columns, but where we are placing, up to what level it is reaching is important. Okay, so let's say, for example, when I select this column in the property, I can see the base level and top level, where it is starting and where it is reaching. Okay, but when I select this column, I can see base level ground floor, top level ground floor, but it should reach into the first level. Okay, so to check these things, I use the section command. So before going to the section, I want to discuss a little bit about this. Okay, here we have the, for example, terminology, floor plan, section. Floor plan means if you cut the building horizontally, we'll get the floor plan. Okay, not exactly top view. Top view is a different, floor plan is different. If you cut the horizontally, we get the floor plan. If you cut the vertically, we get the section. I hope everybody understood this. Okay. Now I want to create one section here. To create the section, I will go to the view. Remember, view. Here we have the section. Select it and draw first point, second point. Okay. Right click, go to view. I will enter into the section drawing. This is a crop boundary. The section. Okay, can you see? This is my section, right? Here, this is my ground floor plan. I placed the column in the ground floor. When I select it, it's showing base level ground floor. When I go to the section, it is coming to the below the level. Okay, these are the levels. If I want to make extend this level, select it, go to the and hold the small circle part and drag and drop. It will cross this grid also. This is a presentation part. Okay, now when I select this column, where it is showing below the ground, but it should go upside, other side of the ground level in the section. Okay, select any one of the column, go there, base level is ground floor, go to the top level as a first floor. Here we have the base offset, it should be making to the zero. Okay, select all columns in the section or in the ground floor, wherever you want. Okay, see, select, go to the ground base level and top level should be first floor, offset is zero. Okay, let's say select all columns, base level ground floor, top level first floor, top offset should be zero. So now let us see the section rank. Go to view, so you can see above the ground level. Up to where it is reaching? It's reaching into first level. But for example, I want to extend it to the second level, select the column. Top level, if you change into the second level, it will increase to the second level. But it's not correct process. We should draw the columns level to level only. Why, we will discuss in future. Okay? Level to level only. Next, I'm going to the ground floor. Now I want to copy all columns. Select one column. Let's say I want to select the columns here. Okay. Select the columns. When I select the things by window, top left to bottom right, in this we have the dimension and columns. But here I want to select only columns, means I need to filter it. Okay. When I select things like this, here I'm getting enabled by the filter command. Go to the filter, uncheck the dimension. So now I can able to select only structure columns. Okay. Go to the copy command. Multiple. First point. Okay. Can you see? Now I want to see this drawing into the 3D. See, if you go to the project browser, here we have the 3D views. If you go to the view, here also we have the 3D view. If you click on the 3D view, our 3D drawing will get prepared. Go to the point for the better visibility and shade it. These are the columns. Okay, simple thing. Go to the floor plan, go to structure, choose the column, choose the type of the column and place it, size of the column. Okay. Here important thing is, after placing one column, we need adjust the levels, base level and top level, where it is starting, where it is reached. Clear? To create the different size of the column, let's say I want to copy these columns aside. Simple process. This is a very important process. Select the column, go to the edit type. Okay. Duplicate. Let's say I want to create 800 by 800 column. 800 by 800. It's a name only. Okay. Here we need to change the 800. 800. Okay. Let's say I want to copy. Next. I want to create one more size. Let's say 400 by 400, 400. Edit type, duplicate, name, 400 by 400. Again, I need to change the size, 400 by 400. Okay, copy. Let's say I want to create one more column. Okay. So here I'm going to edit type process. Remember, duplicate. Let's say 750 by 1500. This is 750 and 1500. Okay. Copy multiple. So to create, always I am going to edit tab, duplicate. For example, if I not duplicate, what will happen? Okay, if you select the column, go to the edit type, here see, direct, I'm not doing any rename of this column, just I'm changing the dimension. Let's say for example 200 by 1500. See what will happen? All columns with that names all get modified. Okay, so it is nothing but redefine in AutoCAD. So don't do these things. If you want to create new size, just select it, duplicate and create new size. Okay. See, all get affected. For example, I want to change this column to this column. Okay, select it, go to the choose dimension, whatever you want. Let's say I want to choose 750 by 1500. Okay. See, if you want to change into the different size, select it 300 by 450. You can change it. You have to select the object, go to the property, change the size. If you want to create the new size, select the column, go to the edit type, duplicate, give the name and change the dimension. Okay. Let's say here I want to go add one more command. For example, this column is 800 by 800. This column is 750 by 1500. I want to match this property to this property. Okay. Here, if you go to the modify, remember modify in the clipboard, I have the option called match property. Okay. Shortcut is MA. If you go to the match property, select this property to this property. Automatically you can change any property. Okay, go to the match property, change. Understood? Match property, modify, and match property. You can change any size. Okay, let's say for example I want to change the different size. Let's for example 755. I want to make all sizes. Go to the match property, select one by one. So match property. Okay, if you want to delete, select all those things and delete. So now how to create the different size is clear for everyone. Different size means type in Ruby. I hope everybody understood this statement. Okay. So now I want to change this dimensions. I'm going to the property. I'm changing the type. Okay. Why I'm calling type is if I want to create a new size, if you go to the edit type, it's a terminology in the Revit. It's a type. Size nothing but type. Okay. Size nothing but type. So here. If you select this column, go to the edit type, here type as well. Always we need to select the object, go to the edit type, change the object. This is a process. Okay. After placing the columns in one floor, select it and where it is started and where it is end, ground floor to first. It's clear for everyone. Save. If you want to see the 3D drawings, go to the view. And see the column. Now, shall we stop for the day? Any questions on this?
No, sir.